Hi friends, welcome back to another video. In today's video, I'm going to simplify the data science job family, specifically the role that is titled data scientist generalist. If you have watched some of my previous videos, you already know that the whole data science job family, specifically when it comes to definitions, it's all messed up. The titles do not match the job descriptions, and job descriptions do not match the titles. And the problem gets even bigger when you compare one role to a different company, because a data scientist at company X does not mean the same at company Y. I have been thinking about this problem and I wanted to share my solution and how we can simplify the data scientist role further to make sure that there is no confusion around what data scientist actually does. And there is one company that is actually doing it well, and I will share that company name toward the end of the video, and as well as share some of their job descriptions that you can look at and see what exactly are they doing correct that makes it easy to understand what are the expectations for a data scientist role. So with that, let's jump into the video. And if you find the information that I share today, make sure to give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel if you want to hear more about data science, tech lifestyle, career tips, and everything else in between. All right, so let's talk about the data scientist generalist role, what it is. So look at this diagram. So this diagram is basically the data scientist generalist role that we're talking about is basically the middle part, where it's a mix of engineering, mix of statistics, mix of machine learning, mix of business understanding, as well as data analytics. So this is basically the role is a central role, which combines understanding of all the areas and serves more as a generalist, where you are typically not really going into deep machine learning, building models from scratch, but rather using the existing libraries, existing models, and applying it to solve the business problem. However, the problem with that is that since this role covers everything, it can get confusing real quick. And it's very easy for one company to take that role and move it into the left of the diagram and move it to the right of the diagram, or move it to the bottom of the diagrams. So when we think about data science generalist role, there are typically three areas that somebody could be working on. One is they can either be like building metrics. They could be either looking at business and trying to understand what metrics we are going to measure, how to improve a certain metric and things like that. The second area that could be more around like hypothesis testing, where you are trying to run experiments and trying to do a lot of experimentation and trying to understand what actually works well and what doesn't. And then there is like a third area, which is more around the machine learning side of things, where you are actually building models, you have a very good understanding of mathematics, and you are able to use that machine learning knowledge and are able to solve business problem by applying those machine learning models. So these are the basically three areas that I see a data scientist generalist role focusing on. However, the problem is that when you combine all those three roles into one, it can get confusing pretty quickly, and it can get intimidating pretty quickly, because it's very hard for one person, one role, to be very good at all of these three areas. I have been in data science roles where some of them are very analytics focused and other ones are very experimentation focused. Now, is it realistic to expect one person to be very good at all those three areas? Probably no. So I think what a good solution and how we can divide this job family further into a more simplistic job descriptions that is easy to understand and replicate across company to company. So that would be turning this role into three roles. So there would be a data scientist who focuses primarily on analytics. This is something similar to what Facebook's current data scientist does. It's primarily focused on analytics and a bit of hypothesis testing. Then there is the second role, which is data scientist inference, and that is primarily focusing on like experimentation and things like that and hypothesis testing. And then we have a data scientist who is primarily focused on machine learning, and they are primarily working with business to solve the business problems. All three roles work with the business, but this role specifically works on solving problems using machine learning. So data scientist, analytics, data scientist, inference, data scientist, machine learning. So I promised to show you one company that has been doing this well. And the company that I am talking about is Airbnb. If you go to Airbnb's career website and you look for data scientists, you will actually come across three different data scientist focus areas, and those three different focus areas would be exactly this. And if you look at the job description, the first line of the job requirement, it would be very clear to you what does data scientist analytic does, what does data scientist inference does and what does data scientist machine learning does. I give kudos to Airbnb for coming up with this. This is not something I came up with. This is something Airbnb came up with and I got to learn about it while I was interviewing at Airbnb. And when you are interviewing with them, they actually give you the option. They ask you like, okay, what kind of data science work do you want to do? And based on that, they will basically give you interview, and the interview for all those three would be very, very different. Now, in other companies, what is happening is that their data scientist is like a mumbo jumbo of everything, so which leads to interviews being very, very different from company to company. So I think if more companies adopt what Airbnb is doing with their data science job family, I think we can solve this problem of having a mumbo jumbo of data scientist role, which is somewhat unrealistic. And I didn't even touch on data engineering part. A lot of the companies expect you to do data engineering work as a data scientist, which is completely unrealistic. I come from a data engineering background. Yes, having the data engineering concepts and did help me as a data scientist, but it's I don't think a data scientist should be spending their time doing the data engineering work. So that's all I wanted to share. Let me know in comments, what are your thoughts on this three pillars of data science role? Do you think that would solve the current problem that we have in the industry where there is a lot of struggle when it comes to job search, job interviews, as well as like day to day, because it's very hard for people to understand and for you to sometimes understand what you're supposed to do and what you are supposed to focus on. So with that, thank you so much for watching. I hope this was helpful. And let me know in comments, what are your thoughts on this topic? And I hope you're having a great day. I'll see you in the next video. Bye.